Gentlemen, we have a graphic. Let's take it right now if we can and walk us through it. Number one is not surprising at all. Osteoporosis, Dr. Geronemus.
Yes, osteoporosis it makes up the bulk of these fractures. You know, there's over 10 million patients with osteoporosis in the United States annually. And it's really the risk factors for osteoporosis are age, gender. Women are significantly more prone and at a younger age. Your bone mineral density, certain medications. There's a lot that goes into it, but by far, osteoporosis is your biggest risk factor for vertebral compression fractures.
I know for women that time of menopause is also very critical, where you lose a lot of bone mass, right?
Absolutely. We do know that it is estrogen dependent. Unfortunately, they've done studies where with estrogen replacement it actually does not help, in that they found that the risk outweigh the benefits of using the estrogen for bone density.
All right, and we have two more on that graphic, which we'd want to show our viewers real quick. The next one was trauma, I believe, and then the third one finally was pathologic compression fracture. Would you like to chime in on that, Dr.
Right.
Skiro?
So trauma is very, very common. Actually, patients that have just minor falls, it's considered that the patient has had a trauma, especially in patients that are osteoporotic. If they have a fall, that trauma can result in some significant compression fractures and result in severe pain. I've actually had younger patients that have had real trauma, such as automobile accidents, boating accidents. I actually had one patient that came in with a plane accident one time that had a compression fracture as a result of that.